We want to find the exact trig function values using reference triangles. Notice how the angles are given in radians, so we could convert these to degrees, but I think it's important to learn how to work with radians as well. So we'll sketch these angles in standard position, form the reference triangle, and then determine the trig function values. So we'll first sketch 7 pi over 4 radians in standard position. So here's the initial side. Now we'll start to rotate counterclockwise. Well, half a rotation counterclockwise would be pi radians, but because our angle is a multiple of pi over 4 radians, it's helpful to view this as 4 pi over 4 radians, which means from here, we need to rotate another 3 pi over 4 radians. Well, one complete rotation counterclockwise would be 2 pi radians, which is equal to 8 pi over 4 radians. So we could also think of this as we have to rotate 1 pi over 4 radians less than 8 pi over 4 radians, which means we would rotate somewhere in here pi over 4 radians short of one complete rotation. So this would be the terminal side, and we should recognize that the angle between the terminal side and the x-axis is pi over 4 radians. If we rotated one more pi over 4 radians, we would be at 8 pi over 4 radians. So now we can form our reference triangle by sketching a perpendicular to the x-axis here. So here's our reference triangle in black. And because we know that pi over 4 radians is equal to 45 degrees, we know we can label the two legs of this right triangle as 1 and the hypotenuse as square root 2. But we also have to make sure that we have the right signs on the legs. And since we're in the fourth quadrant, where the x-coordinate is positive and the y-coordinate is negative, this 1 must be negative. And now we can use this reference angle and this reference triangle to determine these first two trig function values. So the sine of 7 pi over 4 radians is equal to the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse, which is negative 1 divided by square root 2. So this is the exact value for this trig function, but sometimes we are asked to rationalize the denominator, so let's also do that. To rationalize the denominator, we'd multiply by the square root of 2 over the square root of 2. So this would be negative square root 2 divided by 2. So again, depending on your directions, you may be able to express your answer in this form or this form. And now for the cosine of 7 pi over 4 radians, we need the ratio of the adjacent side to the hypotenuse, which would be positive 1 divided by square root 2. So if we rationalize the denominator like we did up here, the only difference is we would have positive square root 2 over 2. So again, these values are equal. One has an irrational denominator, and one has a rational denominator. Now for the next two, we'll sketch negative 3 pi over 4 radians and form our reference triangle. So because our angle is negative, we'll now rotate clockwise 3 pi over 4 radians. Well, 1 quarter rotation clockwise would be negative pi over 2 radians, but because our angle is a multiple of pi over 4 radians, it's helpful to view this as negative 2 pi over 4 radians, which means we need to rotate another pi over 4 radians clockwise, which would bring us to here. So here's our terminal side. So if this is negative 3 pi over 4 radians, and half a rotation would be negative pi or negative 4 pi over 4 radians, we know that our reference angle here must be pi over 4 radians. So now we'll form the reference triangle. Again, because we have a pi over 4 right triangle, or 45, 45 right triangle, we can label the two legs 1, the hypotenuse square root 2. But now we're in the third quadrant, where both the x-coordinate and the y-coordinate are negative. So this will be negative 1, and so will this. So the sine of negative 3 pi over 4 radians is equal to the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse. So we'd have negative 1 divided by square root 2. Or if we want to rationalize the denominator, we would have negative square root 2 over 2. And notice for the cosine function value, we'd have the ratio of the adjacent side to the hypotenuse, which is still negative 1 divided by square root 2. Or negative square root 2 over 2. That's going to do it for these two examples, but I will leave you with some notes on the 45-45-90 reference triangle, or the pi over 4 reference triangle. This is the triangle that we used, but of course we could multiply each length by a constant. So if the constant was x, we could also express this reference triangle in this form here. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.